What's poppin', y'all? It's a special edition of What You Mean Films. We got my Green Bay Packers ahead of this San Francisco matchup, and we're going to go over their game plan that I think they should run against the 49ers. Now we're going to go over the offensive and defensive scheme, as well as holes in their defense and offense that I think they should address. All right, the keys to the game for the Green Bay Packers offense is be cover three, get ahead of the sticks, get good protection, no turnovers, and have about 120 yards rushing and about 20 to 25 attempts, because the attempts are just as important as the yards in a game like this. Now, the 49ers have an aggressive defensive line. Now, what do you do with an aggressive defensive line? You let them play themselves out of position. Perfect play to run against this is the draw play that you see the Cardinals run here. They let the 49ers defensive line get upfield. They got a good block with their center who double teams and works up to the linebacker, and they get good positive gain, and running back goes hard and runs upfield. Now, this play shows why the attempts are just as important as the yards gained. Now, not every time you run the ball, you're going to get a great gain, but because you are running the ball, they have to respect it. Now, here the corner or the slot blitzer comes too far on the inside of giving Kyler Murray the ability to roll out and have an ability to see the receiver streaking across and hit him right across the middle. Now, you're going to see it here from the tight view. The slot blitzer is going to come in. Oop, he's going to have to readjust himself and give Kyler Murray time to throw the ball and make a good completion. Now, the Packers have not done good with cover one or man defenses. Now, the Lions ran this against us, you know, on that one fateful night in Green Bay, and it was a bit troubling without Devontae Adams. We have to be able to beat cover one because they will mix up their coverages. Although they do run a lot of cover three in San Francisco, they can run man, and when they do run man, we must win like here on this play. Beating the zone is all important with the right routes. All right, they're going to run two clear out routes with the slot and the number two receiver and have the number one receiver come streaking across. Now, it was a drop, but had he caught this with his speed, I believe he could have scored. We're going to look at it again from the tight view. The 49ers are only going to bring about four people. Then you're going to see the receiver come streaking across right there on top of the logo, but he drops the pass. Now, when you got a defensive line like the 49ers, you need to get the ball out quick. Don't play around. Get the ball on these edges and let somebody make a play. Now, Kyler Murray gets the ball out quick. The receiver gets upfield quick, and you got fantastic blocking by the rest of the receivers. Do not mess around when you have a team that is this versatile and this aggressive. You need to get the ball out and start moving right now. Beating cover three is a very essential part of the Packers game plan because the 49ers run a lot, as far as I see. Now, in cover three, the corners often bail and they have their eyes on the quarterback, no longer the receiver. So if the receiver can snap the route off right as the cornerback is looking back and come back to the ball, it should be a fairly easy completion for an NFL receiver and an NFL quarterback, as you see here on this play, even on a corner like Richard Sherman, who is a very, very good cornerback. Keep good defenses on their toes, especially good defensive line. Now, here you're going to see that the Cardinals move the launch point. They purposely roll the pocket to the left so that the defensive line isn't just pinning their ears back, flying upfield. You do not want that, especially when you have a young quarterback and a pretty much overall young team, okay, going against one the top team in the NFL. Move around, make them think. Spread the defense out. Let them show you what they trying to do. The Cardinals gonna come out in five wide and run a quick little screen to their running back. They put the ball in their playmaker's hand and let him make a play. The pass rush is null and void in a play like this because the ball comes out so quick. All the pass rushers do or have enough time to do is put their hands up and run about 2 to 3 yards upfield and have to turn around and start chasing down some running back. This is a fantastic play to run, and if executed well, can cause headaches for a team like the 49ers. He catches the ball, gets up just past the 50, almost to the 60-yard line. All right, now the defensive game plan is pretty simple, and I'm pretty sure it's what everyone's been trying to do against the 49ers, which is stop the run, get them to third and long, do not take the cheese as in the bait or any trickery, and force turnovers. Let's get it. Put the ball in Jimmy G's hands. Several times throughout a lot of games, especially this Cardinals game, he forces passes. Right here, he does not see the linebacker sitting right here in the hook zone, and it cost them about at least 3 points and probably 7. This is a critical part in the game, and Jimmy G just didn't see. We're going to look here from the tight view. You're going to see Hicks does not move much. He's sitting right there, and I'm sure he was surprised he got the ball. He had to do nothing, catch the ball, hit him right in his chest. Looked like he was go-to receiver on that play. He catches the ball. He gets downfield. All right, here goes another play with another interception. Now, this one was not directly thrown to the other team, but it was high, wide, and wild. All right, you're going to see he tries to hit the tight end there. It goes behind him, and the Cardinals take advantage of the play. I do not know where Jimmy G, or I know where he was looking. His mechanics were a little bad. Yes, he did have some pressure, but at this point in the game, or at any point in the game, when your defense, you know, has been doing good but not amazing, particularly in this game, you have to help them out, and this is not how you do it. Jimmy G is the one issue with this San Francisco team other than injuries. All right, here goes another time where he is staring down his receiver, and you cannot do that with a man like Luke Kuechly, Superman for the Carolina Panthers. All right, you're gonna see him, he's staring and staring, he undercuts it, boom. Not only did he stare down his receiver, the throw was behind the receiver. So he had no chance at all of completing this play. All right, we're going to look at it again from the tight view. Kuechly is sitting right there staring at him. He's playing the zone coverage. All right, he's sitting right here in the hook zone. You're going to sit here. He's going to sit here, coming across, undercut. Thank you. All right, there's going to be a similar play that in the Seahawks game. All right, here goes another interception that he throws. All right. He throws the ball deep. It's high. It's, you know what I'm saying, where the receiver has to extend their body too far. Now, I'm not saying that, you know, the receiver should be bailed out in this, you know what I'm saying, but I don't think this is a catchable ball. 84 is sitting right here. All right, he's going to bend out, and look where this ball goes. High, ooh, and it's picked off. In a divisional game, man, you cannot have that. Put the ball where only your receiver can get it. Put it right on his numbers. Don't make it that hard. All right, look at this pass right here. Should have been intercepted by B. Wag. This is nearly identical to the play versus Carolina. Okay, you're gonna see him stare down his receiver. All right, and B. Wag gets this. Should have been in the game, but he dropped it on the same drive. All right, KJ Wright, another linebacker, should have had the interception to end the game right there. Hits him square in his chin. Drops the money. All right. Fortunately, that Seattle actually still won this game with all the dropped interceptions and interceptions that were called back. It was like San Francisco was trying to give up the game, specifically Jimmy G. Now, let's get to the run game. You have to stop their run game so we can get to Jimmy G throwing the ball. Now here, although Aaron Donald does make a freakishly good play, you got to see what started this play. All right. They sealed off the edge. They forced it back inside. So had Aaron Donald not made this amazing, just whoop, get up off me, all right, they still would have had a tackle for loss. Okay, this, you have to cut off the cutback lanes and you have to force it back inside, because these running backs at any point in time can't hurt you. Here it goes again. They're cutting it back, and the Cardinals, who don't have like the best defense, are doing a pretty good job against the run, and you have to be consistent against the run, because anytime you get too complacent and you think everything is going well, bam, that's when they hit you. Because at any given point in time, they can hit you with a home run, like right here against the Browns. You're gonna see Breida takes the ball from, what is that, the 17 yard line, bad angle by the safety, and deuces, he up out of the, he about to go score a touchdown, and in a blink of an eye. You have to play gap sound defense versus this San Francisco running attack. Okay, they run a zone scheme. He's going to follow the fullback. It's a counter play. Boom, kicks out, and he's gone. Okay, the safety, Demarius Randall, I believe that is, former Packer, takes a bad angle. And, hey, shows why we don't need him on the team. Now, even with all that I just went over, I just want to make one thing clear. If the Green Bay Packers go to California like they went to last time versus them Chargers and get stumped out again, we will get blown out by these 49ers, all right? This defense needs to step up. No big plays. Make them march down the field. Make them march down. Do what you're supposed to do every play. I don't know. That's a lot to ask, but, hey, that's what we need. And offense, hey, we need to make plays, not with just the two players you see on your screen, Adams and Jones, but Jamal Williams, Alan Lazard, MVS, Geronimo. No drop passes, okay? Keep that to a very, very low minimum, and let's make sure we get some good protection on Rodgers, all right? We can beat this team, okay? Most certainly, most definitely. And if we beat them now, like Rodgers said, we ain't got to beat them later. Anyway, y'all, that's it. appreciate y'all watching, man, this new type of video I'm doing, you know, especially for my Packers fans out there. This is a little preview, a little matchup preview of what I think is going to happen. I hope that my Packers come out. I think the final score is going to be about 24-17 Packers. All right, we're going to go down there, upset them, let everybody know that we ain't playing around.